Hi, I'm Oliver, age 24, and I run a YouTube channel called How to Draw Really Good. And you're watching a speed run of me drawing the front cover of Dan Bull's new album, Generation Gaming II. Honestly, I've got no idea what the II stands for, but the first one was called Generation Gaming I, so I'm guessing this one has got twice as many eyes, which probably means it's twice as good. Now to begin with, I didn't know what to draw, but I did know that Dan Bull is a rapper. So what I did is I googled rap lyrics and I drew some of the things that came up a lot in a lot of the songs. So they were things like money and naked girls and golden chains and guns, and that was pretty much it really. So before I started drawing, I had a quick discussion of these ideas with Dan, and Dan said it was good, but it wasn't really what he was thinking, and he kind of wanted something a little more gaming related, and I wasn't quite sure how rap and gaming fit together. So what I did was, I just drew the idea that I came up with, and then I gave all the naked girls and Dan Bull Nintendo Game Boys, because I'm pretty sure that's a modern gaming console. I don't really know. Anyway, in this video I'm supposed to be going through the songs and telling you what's on here, but I don't know any of the songs, so I'm going to have a guess as to what the songs are about. So track one is called DLC PLC, and I think that stands for Dogs Like Cats, People Like Cars. I don't really know what he's trying to say with that, but it's a clever title. So track two is called I Lead the League of Legends. Now I'm not really sure what the League of Legends is, but if I had to guess, I'd say it was a rap gang or like a gun gang, sort of like Dan's mob of people that do crimes together. Now track three is called Battlefield, and it could be a song about war or something, or it could be like a metaphor, and Dan is saying that his body is like a battlefield. I don't know what that means either. Maybe he got really ill one time and he fought through it and it was like a battlefield. Track four is called Diablo 3. I think Diablo is the Spanish word for devil, so maybe it's a song about freeing the devil. Maybe. Track five is called Pitch Invasion, the invasion of pitch. I think that one speaks for itself, really. Track six is called The Bard's Secret, and it's probably that the bard isn't even a bard at all, and that's his secret. Track 7 is called Arkham Asylum, and it's probably about all of the crazy things that go on in a mental institution. Track 8 is called Iron Man Mode, and I'm not sure where Mode comes from, but I think it's a cover of Iron Man by Black Sabbath. I might listen to that actually, it sounds quite good. Track 9 is called Back to the Borderlands. And I'm guessing that on the first album was a song called The Borderlands, and this is a follow-on to that song, I guess. Track 10 is called Dishonored, and I reckon that's a song about a time when Dan Bull shot somebody in his own rap group, which is something that you can't do if you're a serious gang member. Bang, bang, bang. That was me shooting my imaginary gun. But Dan Bull's got a real gun because he's a real rapper. Track 11 is called Fly and it features Dave Brown. And I'm pretty sure I had an English teacher in school called Dave Brown. I'm not sure if it's the same guy, but that would be quite funny. Actually, no it wouldn't, because one time Mr. Brown gave me a detention because somebody else threw my pencil case on the floor. Why would I throw my own pencil case on the floor? I don't know. You tell me, Mr. Brown. You tell me. The last song is called Halo 4, and I'm not sure what happened to 3, 2, and 1, unless all three of them were on the last album, and that'd be a bit weird to have three songs with the same name on one album, so I don't really know what happened there. So that's fantastic. That's the whole album. I've explained it to you, and I've shown you how I drew the cover, And all that's left is to say, go buy this album, because Dan Bull obviously spent a long time writing all of these songs. And as you can see, it took me years to draw the album cover, so you should buy it for that reason as well. So on your screen now should be a button to subscribe to my channel, a button to subscribe to Dan Bull's channel, and a button to buy this album on iTunes. Fantastic. It's probably the best and most vicious gangster rap album in the entire world. You should probably own it. Goodbye. Dan Bull, Google me.